This is question number 3 from our top 40 most asked questions from brand new vendors or vendors just about to start. And, you almost get cold feet because all these things come to mind. What if this and what if that and how many of these? And so we're continuing on with that. If you've missed the first ones, you can go to learnhotdogs.com and you'll see them down the page there. As we add blog articles, you'll see them numbered there. This will be number 3. And this is called What If I Mess Up? And what I'd like to say here is you really think you're going to go out and not make mistakes. Hellfire, I've been doing this for years and still make mistakes. But what's just fantastic, no one is really going to notice. Let's say you grab the ketchup when you meant to grab the bouillon seasoning and you squeeze some into the boiling water. Yeah, I keep my water seasoned so that it is saturated with flavors. You get a big line and don't remember what hot dog you're making right this moment because the guy in second in line was telling you how good yesterday's meal was. Sir, I don't remember what you wanted on this. Was it anchovies or Oreo cookie crumbles? More than likely, they will laugh and then repeat the order. I was nervous in the beginning, very nervous, and trying to do my best to work through a line of about 6 people. When I took an order for 2 hot dogs plain, nothing on them. About the same time, a lady walks up and interrupts and says, "Yeah, I just bought this hot dog and it's not hot at all." While preparing and packaging these hot dogs that were supposed to be plain, I added mustard and ketchup. The customer called my attention to it and said, "Oh," I said, "I'm sorry. Let me redo that quickly." While I opened 2 more hot dog sleeves and grabbed the buns, I began talking to this lady that had just shown up. "Ma'am, I'm so sorry. What can I help you with?" "Well, I bought these hot dogs and it's cold as a wedge." "No problem. I'm very sorry about that and I'll fix you a fresh one," or something to that effect. I was very kind. Now this lady, I remembered her because when she ordered some 2 hours earlier, her breath was so horrid that it almost melted my eyelids off. Instead of arguing the fact that the hot dogs don't have a heat retention for 2 hours, I just attempted to finish the order I was on and then give her a new hot dog. Well, again, I prepared the 2 hot dogs while talking, and again, I put ketchup and was stopped just before adding mustard. So this guy that I had already screwed up his plain hot dogs once, I had screwed him up again. I was so embarrassed, but smiled and quickly fixed it right away, handed him his order, and told him it was on the house. I then made the ladies' meal, and she left. Now, I made some mistakes, but no one there really recognized those as mistakes. And if they did, they didn't care, because one gentleman got a free meal, the other person got her cold dogs replaced. So, not a big loss there for me. You know, I may have lost a couple or 3 bucks, but I more than made that back from other customers in line, plus the fact that these people will be back. Hopefully the cold hot dog lady doesn't. But once I actually grabbed a styrofoam hot dog container and I picked up the ladle and I poured the chili right inside. I had forgotten the bun and the hot dog. I turned to the customer and tilted the container so to show her what I had done and said, "What would you like next, the bun or the hot dog?" And she looked confused. And then saw that I had begun laughing, and she laughed too. Grabbing another container, I prepared her meal, and then she left. Not only did I turn my mistake into a fun moment, the customer remembered it too, and she shared it with others. She was back the following week and brought it up and explained how she thought it was so funny that I turned this mistake of mine into a joke. You may actually make larger mistakes. You may show up to a huge event like a friend of mine did, only to find you left your propane tanks at home. I once forgot to stop and get ice for my drinks, and only discovered the problem after I was alone and cooking and had already started, and the first customer opened the cooler to find warm drinks inside. My friend, I mentioned, had to delay his opening, but still had a fantastic day once he was able to get propane. I already had a line on mine and signs hanging up that said that we had a combo meal, and I couldn't take those down right then because I was trying to prepare. So as they'd ask for a combo meal, I'd say, "No, we don't have a combo meal. The drinks are warm," basically. So during a break, I took my special combo meal off the dry erase board, and I wrote soft drinks BYOI, and below it I wrote it, bring your own ice. So I don't know how many people got it, but especially I know the people that got it are the ones that asked me for a drink, and I explained that they were warm. Another vendor down the way a little bit saw my sign while he was getting lunch for me, and he offered to have an employee bring me a couple bags and save my day. I could go on and on, but as you get more comfortable, you'll get better and better at what you're doing. Eventually, it will all be second nature, and guess what? You'll still screw up. Once I put on a glove to take the money from a customer, but then pulled it off and began preparing the next order. We are human, and humans make mistakes. But we aren't a hospital or an emergency room. There really aren't any hot dog emergencies. But, you know, only events that make us feel like emergencies. Make the best of your mistakes and stay positive and have fun. Something else I want to mention before I close is that you can always throw in some comedy and just make light of a bad situation in a lot of cases. I've had a lady bring me back a dog that she opened it. It was for her kid, and it had a hair on it. Well, as you know, I'm bald-headed. It wasn't my hair. More than likely, it was her child's or hers. But I replaced it. I didn't argue it. I took it and said, oh, I'm sorry about that. Let me get you another one. And I fixed up another hot dog, and off they went. Typically, if you can think of it quick enough, usually I'm pretty quick-witted. And so, but you can practice this stuff. It's not like comedians go out there and just ad-lib. And so you can memorize little things to say in different situations. You know, somebody brings you back a dog with a hair on it, and you go, oh, that's standard on that. We don't charge extra for it. And then go ahead and make them another dog. Anything like that. Now, you shouldn't be getting hair in the food, but there's all these other circumstances because there's other people around. And surely one of the other customers in a line, hair could have blown in the wind. You couldn't have seen it. And as you closed it up, bam, a hair got on the dog. So that could happen. And it probably is going to happen to you at some point or another. It's all part of doing business. You can go work at Walmart if you want, bagging groceries, and you're still going to have an issue where the bottom drops out of the bag or something. So this is just called life, and I just want to ease your tensions, ease your fears that, yes, there's things that can happen. Most people aren't going to recognize it. Nobody's going to recognize if you don't have a good system yet, a good flow yet. They're not going to recognize that, oh, he's supposed to be using the ladle in his right hand because that's how most vendors do it, and he's back and forth with the ladle. And a lot of new vendors are. They're back and forth because they pick up the lid with their right hand, and then they got the ladle in the left, but they're right-handed, so they switch the pan lid over to the left hand and then grab the ladle with the right. Nobody cares, and nobody notices. Just move on. Have fun and smile, and you'll make lots of money, and you'll make lots of people happy. And the more personal you can make it, feel and seem, do it. I've had people come in line that I've never seen before when I was working a regular spot, and you get these new people up, and they're in line, and you know, they're some of them are hesitant because they just never been to a vendor. And I'll go, oh my gosh, John, 13 times today? I can't believe you can eat this many hot dogs. And I just broke the ice with that person. They're going, what the heck? My name's not John. And number two, I'm a woman. And number three, I've never been here before. So there's all these little things you can do and play and have fun. And you don't have to be a comedian to pull it off. You can do it. Just smile. And you'll make up more money. And don't worry about other people and how they perceive it, because you are going to be harder on yourself than anyone else. And these people have never ran a hot dog cart, and they don't know how it's done. So they wouldn't recognize the mistake if it hit them upside the head. So you could probably serve your hot dogs from the bottom of your cart, flip your cart over, and they probably wouldn't notice the problem. I'm being a little facetious, but The bottom line is, don't worry. I wish you all well. We'll have more of these to come. If you would like to see over 150 videos and all kinds of free stuff, it's all free. Go to learnhotdogs.com. Type in the search word for anything you're looking for, from commissaries to how do I do lemonade from a hot dog cart. We have the information there, and it's free. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.